Welcome to Deborah Rise. I'm Prophetess Mary Kraft, and I am so excited you're joining me in my series, How to Avoid Becoming a False Prophet. This is where we look at scriptures to learn what to look for in a false prophet and how to avoid doing things that false prophets do. So grab your pen and paper and let's get started. All right, so I'm going to be talking to you and looking at my screen. All right, so let's grab our Bibles and turn to Deuteronomy chapter 13, verses 1 through 3. All right, and I'm going to read it out of three different translations. The first translation I'm going to read out of is the King James Version. It says, "If there arise among you a prophet or a dreamer of dreams, and giveth thee a sign or a wonder, and the sign or the wonder come to pass, whereof he spake unto thee, saying, let us go after other gods, which thou hast not known, and let us serve them. Thou shalt not hearken unto the words of that prophet or that dreamer of dreams. For the Lord your God proveth you to know whether ye love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul." Now I'm going to read Deuteronomy chapter 13, 1 through 3 out of a different translation. This is the New International Version. It says, "If a prophet or one who foretells by dreams appears among you and announces to you a sign or wonder, and if the sign or wonder spoken of takes place, and the prophet says, let us follow other gods, gods you have not known, and let us worship them, you must not listen to the words of that prophet or dreamer. The Lord your God is testing you to find out whether you love him with all your heart and with all your soul." I'm going to read Deuteronomy chapter 13, 1 through 3 out of a different translation. Another one, the Message Bible. It says, "When a prophet or visionary gets up in your community and gives out a miracle sign or wonder, and the miracle sign or wonder that he gave out happens, and he says, let's follow other gods. These are gods you know nothing about. Let's worship them. Don't pay any attention to what that prophet or visionary says. God, your God, is testing you to find out if you totally love him with everything you have in you. You are to follow only God, your God. Hold him in deep reverence. Keep his commandments. Listen obediently to what he says. Serve him. Hold on to him for dear life." Wow. Can you believe that? That the scripture in Deuteronomy chapter 13, 1 through 3 says that if a prophet tells you something and it comes to pass, and then that same prophet tries to get you to serve other gods, gets you to disobey God, do not listen to that prophet, even if what they say come to pass. That prophet is not a true prophet if that prophet prophesies or if that prophet encourages you to live contrary to the word of God. All right. God is warning us that if a prophet prophesies something to you and it comes to pass, and I know you're excited, and I know you're like, wow, that's a true man of God, or wow, that's a true woman of God. But if that prophet that prophesied something true and it comes to pass, and that prophet encourages you to disobey God or encourages you to live contrary to God and serve other gods, then you must not listen to that prophet. All right. Now notice that the Bible said that God is testing you to see if you truly love him with all your heart and with all your soul. Well, that brings us to a cross reference of Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 5, that says, "And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy might." It also cross references Luke chapter 10, verse 27. "And he answering said, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy strength and with all thy mind and thy neighbor as thyself." So Deuteronomy tells us God is testing you to see, do you really love him with all your heart? Or are you so caught up that a prophet prophesied something and it came to pass? You must not get caught up that a prophet prophesies something and it comes to pass. If that prophet encourages you to sin against God, if that prophet encourages you to live a life contrary to God, you must not be blinded just because that prophet prophesied and something come to pass. You must not listen to that prophet. The Bible said, don't even listen to that prophet. All right, so you don't have to be loyal to a prophet that's working miracles, wonders, signs. You don't have to be loyal to a prophet that works in just powerfully, but yet encourages you to live contrary to God. Do not listen to that prophet. That's it for me, Prophetess Craft. I hope I said something that will get you to come back so we can continue learning on how to avoid becoming a false prophet. So we can use scripture to learn what false prophets do, and we can avoid becoming like them.
To make a generous donation to Deborah O'Rise, please cash out $MCraft. Again, $MCraft. A-M-T. We thank you for your continued support.